In this video, I'm going to show you how to make this tilt-shift effect inside of Premiere Pro. The first thing you need to think about when you are going to achieve this effect is that you have some footage that are shot from top down. And I really want to highlight the cars in this clip and make them look miniature. And I really want to make it look a little bit fake, like they're play cars that are playing on the street. So the first thing we need to do is we need to head into the effects panel right here. And I'm just going to search for something called the Gaussian blur. Under video effects and the blur sharpen folder, you will find this Gaussian blur. So we're just going to drag this to our video clip. And then we're going to work with the effect controls panel right over here. And then we have this Gaussian blur effect that we're going to play around with. So the first thing we can do is to turn up the blurriness. So let's try and make this 25 and see how it looks. So that's going to blur out the whole footage. The other thing you really need to think about is to check this box here where it says repeat edge pixels. And then it will get rid of black artifacts around the edges of the video clip. To achieve this effect, we also need to make a mask. So for this tutorial, I'm going to use this 4-point polygon mask. And I really want to drag it. And you need to do this differently depending on your footage. But by watching this example, I think you will get it. So I'm going to drag this and make kind of a thin line. I don't want this to be too thick, so I'm just going to create this thin mask right here, and you can drag this around if you want, but I'm going to place it around there. And then we can go back to the effect controls panel, and we can take and invert it. So now we will have the blurry parts around this mask, and we will have like a clear picture in the middle. So if we take that mask off and see, we'll see that we have starting to resemble the effect that we are looking for. But there are some sharp edges right here, and we need to feather this out a little bit. So inside of the mask properties, we can play around with the feathering of the mask. So it blends a little bit better together, just like so. And I also think that the blur level is a little bit high, so let me take that down to maybe 20, just like so. But we're not done yet. The next thing I really want to do is I really want to make this look a little bit more fake. So to do this, we can choose to color grade. We can open up the Lumetri color panel, and inside of this panel, the first thing we're going to do is play around and make it a little bit more contrasty. A little more punchy. Maybe play around with the highlights as well, so it's not totally overexposed, but a little bit dream look is what I'm going for here. And taking that down the shadows as well, tiny bit down with the blacks, and the whites I really want to have them up a little bit. And then I'm going to use a LUT from my dark cinematic LUTs pack, which I have a link to in the description, by the way. And I'm going to use the LUT called Tokyo 2077. And that will give it a really punchy feel. And the next thing I'm going to do is to increase the saturation, because I really want this to look a little bit more fake. And this is the before, and this is the after we have done the color grade. So right now, it looks a little bit more dreamy, a little bit more unrealistic, and we have achieved the tilt shift effect. On the screen right now, I got another video for you to watch next. And if you haven't yet, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell. Create and inspire, and I will see you in the next video.